After installing CapCut for desktop on your operating system, whether that's Windows or Mac OS, this is the startup screen you should be seeing. This is the 2024 version of CapCut, and this is pretty much a welcome screen, if you will, to get you started. For those of you that are in a hurry and want a general overview of the video editing process and want to put something out as quick as possible, I'm going to give you a quick rundown of the most basic video editing process using CapCut. So as soon as you open up, you're probably going to have to create an account with CapCut. I've already done that. I'm actually using the pro version, but the features that I will cover in this video are all for the free version of CapCut. And while you are on CapCut's official website and you're setting up your account or you're looking to install the software, be sure to look around at some of their web-based tools that you can use directly from their website. You can upload videos to their website, use a lot of their AI tools to create TikTok videos and stuff like that really fast. Some pretty cool stuff on there, so be sure to check that out before you get started using CapCut Desktop. First things first, I'll go over a brief overview of the entire interface here so you know where everything is located. At the very top of the screen, you have the CapCut main menu. There you'll find options for files, edits, your layout, more, help, account, settings, and you can go back to the homepage and quit the app. There is an auto-saved or a saved indicator here beside of that. At the very top center of the screen, you will see the project name. To the right of that, you will see an option for arranging your workspace the way you would like. You can click different options here to change that around. Beside of that, there's a button to bring up your shortcut options, so you can change your keyboard shortcuts around the way you would like them to be, or you can reset them to the default. Beside of that, you'll have a button to access your CapCut account. This is where you can subscribe to the pro account or cancel your subscription, stuff like that. Beside of that is a button to edit your export and sharing options for this particular clip. Beside of that, there is an export button when you're ready to export your file. And then, of course, you have your minimize, full screen, and close buttons. Below that, starting from the far left, we have the media window, which you can see is pulled up right here. This is where all of your files that you've imported are going to be kept, whether that's videos, audio files, stuff like that. There's a tab called Spaces where I believe things that you've saved in the cloud or uploaded media will appear that are directly associated with your account. You'll have a library here. This is stuff that's provided by CapCut. Depending on which subscription you have, there may be more or less here. And this is basically just stock images or images that you can use in your projects that are provided by CapCut. And then you have brand assets. These are images or videos. CapCut has their own brand assets in here. But if you have a logo for a production company or your YouTube channel, you could import that stuff here. In the audio tab, this is where you'll find music, sound effects, stuff like that. A lot of this is provided by CapCut. If you're looking for a song to use with your video and you don't have a subscription to something like Epidemic Sound or anything like that, they have a library of music and sound effects that you can use here. In the text tab, this is where you can create text for your videos. They have AI-generated stuff, auto captions, and then, of course, I have a ton of templates here for different text effects that you can use in your videos. There's a tab for stickers if you want to use some of these goofy little animations and GIFs for your videos. There's an effects tab, tons of different effects to choose from to use in your videos. You can just drag and drop these on any clip in the timeline and it will automatically affect them. You'll see that some of these are labeled with Pro. That's how you can tell if they are only provided in the Pro subscription. The ones without the Pro label are free to use with your free version of CapCut. Here we have transitions. These are different transitions you can place in between the video clips on your timeline to add a little flair to your videos. And here we have video filters. These are just going to change the look of your video clips. You can drag and drop these to your video clips. And here you have the adjustment tab. This is specifically for LUTs or look presets that you can upload to CapCut to affect the look of your footage. Okay, now we can take a look at the main windows here in the interface. In the top left here, of course, we just went over all of this stuff. This is basically the tabs for the media, audio, text, stickers, effects, anything that you click up here in this top left tab is going to appear here in this top left window. And this is the default interface, by the way. Here in the center, you'll see the player window. This is where you can preview your footage. Here you can change the preview quality. You'll see the time code. You can take a look at different aspect ratios with your footage. You can full screen it here. And to the right of that, this is basically where you will see the controls for various aspects of the project, whether that's video, audio, speed, animation, adjustments, and the AI style. As you can see here in the video tab, you can change the scale, the opacity of the particular video clip you have pulled up. You can stabilize the footage, and you'll see some pro features here like image enhancement, relight, noise reduction, AI movement, and AI camera tracking. You can do things like cut out the image, mask around the image, and enhance the image as far as like the face and facial skin smoothing, stuff like that. Here in the audio tab, you can adjust the things like volume, fade in, fade out, loudness normalization. You can enhance the voice, which is a pro feature, noise reduction, and all of that pertains to the specific audio clip that you have selected here in the timeline. Here you have speed, where you can adjust the speed of the clip and whether or not that's going to affect the voice tone and change the sound of the clip as well. Here in the animation tab, you'll see you can add different animations to your footage, like camera shakes and rotations, stuff like that. And here in the adjustments tab, you'll see in-depth controls for changing the colors, looks, saturation, contrast. It's pretty similar to what's featured in Adobe Premiere. You can sharpen, adjust the clarity, add a vignette, stuff like that. And here in AI Stylize, you can add different AI effects to your video clips. Now in the very bottom, this is where our timeline is featured. This is where we're going to do the majority of our editing work. You'll see down here in the center, this is where our video and audio clips actually live. And to the left of it, you can edit the cover, which is basically just a picture that shows up on the timeline so you can recognize the clip more easily. And to the left of that, you'll see buttons for locking the layer on the timeline, hide the layer, you can mute the layer. And above that, you'll see your time code. And then at the top of this window, there are more buttons and controls. You can switch from the select or split mode if you're wanting to cut your clips in a specific area. You have an undo button, which will come in handy, a redo button. And then you have another way of splitting your clips. Just put the cursor where you want to split and click this, and it's going to automatically split that video clip or audio clip for you. You have a delete button. You have a delete to the left button, a delete to the right button, which is going to delete everything to the left or right of the cursor. Then you just have a normal delete button here. Just select the clip you want to delete, and it's going to delete that for you. Here you have a freeze button, which is pretty handy. I find this is handy when you're making things like a tutorial and you want to have the image basically be a picture for a few seconds and linger on one image for a while you talk about something. This button will do that for you. Here you have a reverse button, which is going to reverse your clip and play it in reverse. Here you have a mirror button, which is going to flip it horizontally and mirror the image. A rotate button, which will allow you to rotate the image. A crop ratio, where you can change the image ratio and bring it in a little closer if you need to. And here to the far right, we have a pro feature, which is remove filler words. And this is going to use AI to cut out things in your video clip, like words like and long pauses, stuff like that. And finally, here to the far right, the final buttons on the interface. You have a button for recording audio. There's an option for turning off the track magnet. And the track magnet is going to make your clips automatically magnetized to one another to keep you from having to line things up sometimes. But you can cut that on and off if you want to freely move your clips around on the timeline. You can turn on and off auto snapping. And then you have a zoom to fit, which is going to show you the entirety of your timeline when you hit that button within the window space. And then you have an automatic slider here for zooming in and out on the timeline as well. So to get started, the first thing we're going to do is click on this button here at the top, this purple button that says New Project. And that's going to bring up the main interface in CapCut Desktop, which you can see right now. Next, we need to go to the Import or Add button and import the media files, which could be your videos, images, audio files that you're going to want to edit into your video. You can also drag and drop files directly into the CapCut interface and use them on the timeline. Once imported, your media files will appear in the media library or the timeline if you drag and drop them. To arrange your media clips, you're going to drag and drop the media clips onto the timeline in the desired order that you want them to appear in your video. Use the trimming tools to cut and trim the clips as needed. You can split clips, trim the beginning or end, or trim specific sections. You can also add transitions. If you want to add transitions between your video clips, go to the Transitions tab, choose a transition effect from the available options, and drag it between two clips on the timeline. Now let's talk about applying effects and filters. You can explore the Effects and Filters tabs to enhance your videos. Select an effect or filter and drag it onto the desired clip on the timeline. You can adjust the settings of the effect or filter to achieve the desired look you're going for. You can also add text, titles, and subtitles here as well. Go to the Text or Titles tab to add text or titles to your video. Choose a text style, enter your text, and customize the font size, color, and animation options. You can also drag the text element onto the timeline at the desired position. Every good video needs music and sound effects, and to add background music or sound effects, you're going to go to the Audio tab. Import audio files or choose from the built-in library provided. You can drag the audio clip onto the timeline and adjust its duration and volume as needed. Now let's preview what we put together. Use the playback controls to preview your edited video. Make any necessary adjustments to the timing, effects, or audio levels. You can continue refining your edits until you're satisfied with the result. Once your video looks exactly the way you want, it's time to export it. Once you're happy with your edits, click on the Export or Save button. Choose the desired export settings, including the video format, resolution, and quality. You can select a destination folder for your exported video and click Export to save the final version to your computer. Congratulations, you've successfully edited your first video using CapCut for Desktop. As mentioned earlier, CapCut offers a pretty robust mobile version of its video editing software as well. After downloading the CapCut mobile version to your device and answering a few questions, the app will tailor itself to accommodate what you will best be using it for. At the very top of the app, you'll see the search bar where you can search for different features, a help center menu. You will find the app's main settings. And below that, you will see a drop-down box where you can expand it to see a lot of the built-in and most useful quick features that the app provides, like script-to-video, smart ads, a photo editor, text-to-image, auto-cutting your videos, and a lot of other AI tools. Below that, you'll see the familiar New Project button, which is also featured in the desktop version. This is where you will begin a new project when you first start up the app. Below that, you'll see an Explore tab where you can see some of the app's features in action. And below that, you will see your projects that you have created using the app. At the very bottom of the app, you will see the Edit button, a Template button where you can see a collection of popular templates to create videos quickly and easily, and a button to take a look at your profile in CapCut. Once you click on the New Project tab and grant CapCut access to your photos and videos, you will add any videos or photos that you're wanting to work with, and then you will be brought into CapCut's main interface. From what I can tell, this interface only works in vertical mode. At the top of the editing interface, you'll first see a X icon where you can close out the interface and go back to the home screen. Beside of that, you will see a button that resembles a graduation cap where you can access tons of tutorials to show you the best ways to get the most out of CapCut. Beside that is a flame icon, which right now leads you to a link to download the desktop version of CapCut. And over to the right side, you will see a drop-down box where you can affect the resolution, frame rate, code rate, and turn on smart HDR for your project. And beside of that is an export button to export your project and finished video to your phone's library. Below that is the main preview window where you will see your video project, and you can play that with the play button below. To the left is the expand button, which will full screen your preview window. And to the right is the undo and redo buttons. Below all of this, you will see the main timeline. This is somewhat similar to the timeline in the desktop version. Here you can mute the clip, change the cover here to the left, and beside that you will see the video timeline where you can cut, trim, and edit your clips. Hit the plus button to add another clip, and you can add audio by hitting the add audio button below the video clip. And at the very bottom are your main tools. You can edit the clip. You'll see the split button. You can change the speed, animations, style. You can delete clips. This is where you'll find pretty much everything you need to affect and change the clips that are on your timeline. Everything from adding effects, trimming, clipping, isolating your voice, changing volumes, adding LUTs, stickers, removing the background. Just everything you could think of is down here in these tools. So as you can see, this is a pretty full-featured video editor that you can access on your mobile phone. And I think this is best suited for creating social media content like TikTok and Reels, since it's mainly used in the vertical view mode. If there's a way to use this in a horizontal view mode, I haven't found it yet. If so, please let me know in the comments below. And there you have it. There is a quick look at the mobile version of CapCut as well. And there you have it, guys. There's your beginner's guide to CapCut. What do you think about CapCut? Let me know in the comments below. This channel would be nothing without the constant monthly support of our channel members. Thank you guys so much. If you're interested in becoming a channel member, just click the join button on the main channel page, or you can find a link to that in the description of every video on this channel. Becoming a channel member gives you access to early videos, exclusive behind the scenes videos, members only emojis that you can use in chat, free resources, and much, much more. Don't forget, I just released my Indie Filmmakers Guide that is 100% free. Just follow the link or this QR code on the screen to go download that, no strings attached. It's a great way to get started making your very first film for as little money as possible. As always, I hope you guys found this video very beneficial. I am Ryan, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.